Hey, it's Dave Dolphin at practicalworshipblog.com, sharing ideas, tips, and practical advice for the everyday worship leader. In this video, I want to show you a very quick tip on how to play octave parts easier on the keyboard in MainStage. So let's take the song Forever by Carrie Job, and it has that intro part. It sounds like this. And as you can see with the keyboard in the middle, I'm hitting all those notes. When I do the octaves up here in the right hand, I'm actually really doing an octave with my hand. Well, the problem is that some of my keyboard players don't have really big hands, and those octaves can be really hard to do, and it's really easy to get wrong notes in there. And so there is a trick where you can make your life a little bit easier. Now over here in the channel strip, you've got normal effects like you would see for like EQ, compression, delay, things like that. But you can also add a MIDI effect. And so if we select this and go Chord Trigger, we get this. And so when I play a note, now that sounds like I'm in a club, but the idea is when I hit one note, which is the top part, it actually plays that chord at the bottom. Well, I don't want a chord, I just want an octave. So I want a single interval octave. And now when I play one note, it's actually playing the full octave. Now, a couple things I want to change. I only need the octave for the beginning part. And I'm actually going to play it up here. So I can change what part of the keyboard actually this effect is going to use. So now I have, but I actually notice how when I play a note in that octave, it plays that note and the one above it. I actually want to play the one below it. The easiest way to change that is just to transpose this down an octave. And so you've got, I'm just playing one note, but it comes out as two. And it allows my left hand to be free and not be affected by that effect. So I can, like, I can play my chords for the song. And it's not affected by that effect, but when I want to play the riff, I can do it with only one finger in the right hand. So that's a quick tip on how you can use MainStage to play those octave parts a whole lot easier on your keyboard. Hey, thanks for watching. Here at Practical Worship, we love sharing ideas and tips and practical advice for the everyday worship leader with videos just like this one. So if you haven't already, consider subscribing to the channel. That way you know when new videos hit here at YouTube every single week. If this was helpful, hey, hit that like button. That tells YouTube that this was helpful and gets the information out in front of more and more people. And if you know someone that might benefit from this information, consider sharing it on social media like Facebook and Twitter and places like that. And for more great practical advice, check out practicalworshipblog.com.